So this is totally not the video I expected to be making this morning, but there was some late breaking news that I just wanted to address, and I wanted to address it as quickly as possible. So here we go. Currently, Apple's only answer to television is a starting at 179 box that runs apps and plays up to 4K HDR. But what if there was something else? Something smaller that, instead of sitting beside any TV, could plug right into the back of that TV. Something that gave you all the power of Apple's TV app, but could go with you in a pocket, or maybe was already in your pocket or bag. I've been thinking about this for the last couple of years, but now it looks like the next couple of years could make it a reality. I'm Renee Ritchie. Welcome back to Vector. It's terrific to see you again. Let's do this. Aaron Tilley and Jessica Tunkel writing for The Information just yesterday. To get more viewers for its upcoming TV streaming service, Apple has contemplated going downmarket on its TV hardware. The tech giant has had internal discussions about introducing a low-priced streaming quote-unquote dongle that people could plug into the back of their TV sets, similar to Amazon's Fire Stick or Google's Chromecast, people familiar with the project said. The dongle could make Apple's upcoming video streaming service, which will only be available on Apple devices such as Apple TV, iPhones, and iPads, more widely available. The service will be rolled out globally next year. Shows made originally for Apple will be free on the service. Now, funnily enough, just like I wrote about the iPhone X back in 2015, I wrote about the Apple TV quote-unquote dongle back in 2016. The gist was and is this. It's hard not to look at the Google Chromecast or Amazon Fire Stick and wonder if Apple could make something like it. Don't get me wrong, I love the Apple TV. 4K HDR and all the music, TV, movies, and everything else at the sound of Siri or the click of a controller. It's exactly what I want in my house today. But it's not something I can easily put in my pocket and travel with, be it between cities or simply between friends. In the decade or so since we've gone from the Palm Trio 680 to the iPhone X, the local cable company really isn't providing a better box, and certainly not a better interface than it did back in the age of CRTs. Literally all the innovation in the industry is happening from the outside, from the likes of TiVo, Roku, and yes, Amazon, Google, and Apple. But Apple is, again, currently bound to that box. And that means unless you put the current box in every room of your house and office and take one with you everywhere you travel and go, you may very well be stuck with one of those old, outdated interfaces, or many of them. One of the best things about CarPlay, Apple's automotive infotainment system, is that it lets your device and content take over the interface of any car that supports it, and eliminates the confusion historically associated with everything from upgrades to rentals. AirPlay does something similar for any television, but it needs that Apple TV box to do it. But what if it didn't? What if, like Google's Chromecast or Amazon's Fire dongle, tiny devices that plug into any HD TV with HDMI and lets you stream any of your content and much of the internet's content through them, Apple had an Apple TV Go or Express or Mini or whatever that would let you do exactly the same thing, but with all your Apple content along with the rest of the internet stuff like Netflix and YouTube? The easy way to do it would be to make a dumb dongle, a tiny, presumably cheap piece of hardware that connects over AirPlay and lets you stream anything your iPhone, iPad, or Mac is capable of streaming right to your TV. The interface would stay on your iOS or macOS device, but all the content would push over point-to-point Wi-Fi through the dongle and show up on the big screen. The only downside is that, like with anything AirPlay, it would require a persistent connection to your iPhone, iPad, or Mac, and that limits what else you can do while you're doing AirPlay. A more sophisticated way to do it would be to embed the Apple TV interface on the dongle. It would be a more expensive solution, even with only enough local storage to allow streaming, not local content, but to buffer those streams to ensure steady, stable playback. But it'd also be far more independent. Apple has shown that it can make incredibly small, incredibly dense computational objects. And yeah, there's that term again, with AirPods and Apple Pencil. So making an incredibly small, incredibly dense, incredibly capable streaming stick is certainly within Apple's core competences. And a hybrid approach, something that streams content directly from the internet, all the Netflix, all the YouTube, all the iTunes, but lets you also stream content local from your iPhone, iPad, and Mac, including games that use your iPhone or iPad as a controller, could be incredibly compelling. Even if expensive by current streaming stick standards, and dongles now retail for between $25 and $50, it could be cheap enough by Apple standards to substantially increase living room and every room penetration, which would be great considering Apple has billions of dollars in television content coming next year. Sure, a billion iOS devices with TV.app is certainly a big enough market to support it. Or rather, Apple Television as a value add is certainly a good way to support a billion iOS devices and more on the market to come. And it could also be a way to get people who currently don't have iOS devices but do have a big affinity for everyone from Jennifer Aniston to J.J. Abrams to get something small and easy to try it out with, to be yet another Halo device, this time not from the pocket, but from the living room. And it could also be an even better way to interact with Brilliant. It's a cool website and also an app that helps you learn by getting used to solving interesting problems in science, mathematics, and computer science. And each of the courses, yeah, they start off kind of easy and a lot of fun, but they get more and more challenging as you master the concepts. If you want to learn specifically about computer science, they've got whole courses built around topics like logic, algorithm, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. Go to brilliant.org and start now. Thanks, Brilliant, and thanks to all of you for supporting the show. Now, there's any number of reasons why Apple would never make a TV streaming stick, just like they never made a netbook. But every time I think about it, I really wish they would. And so I want to ask you, would you get an Apple streaming stick? And at what price? What would it have to offer? And what would it have to cost? Hit like, hit subscribe, and then let me know in the comments below. And thank you so much for watching.